Remember? Remember what? That Debbie's dead? You're a liar. I ought to know if she's alive or not. I'm her mother.
Please, Bea, the police have been here twice. You've got to go.
Look, if it's the money I took last night, I'm sorry. I stayed at a motel, but my husband will pay you back.
No, that doesn't matter. Here, take this. It's all I've got, but I can't help you anymore.
Hold it right there. I figured if we watched this place, you'd be back.
What are you doing?
Now, to make an interesting case against you too, Mrs. Brooks. Helping a wanted crim to escape, you're under arrest.
Well, you're not being much of a help, old son.
Well, what was it the women used to call you? Typhoon Terry, wasn't it? And you're asking me for pointers?
What can I help it if I got a weakness for the opposite sex?
Yeah, weakness is right.
Oh, come on, give me some ideas. You know, give me some pointers. Look, what's she interested in,
All right, but only because you're a mate. Right. Well, for a starter, she really likes a bloke to make a fuss of her, you know?
Yeah?
And then she just loves having a good time, mate. Go to parties, discos, all the hot spots, you know?
I knew it. The cooler they are on the outside, the more fun they have when they break loose.
You've got it. It
happens every time.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Harrison.
Would you like some coffee? Tea?
No, thank you.
Just in time you're back on duty, Jim.
Oh, yes, yes. Sorry, I seem to have lost track of time.
Yeah, right, I'll see you later. Well, how'd it go last night?
I beg your pardon?
Well, last night, did you have fun?
It's none of your business, Mr. Harrison.
Had a lousy night last night. Yeah, I was on my own, you see. Oh, no, it's just so long since I've been to the big city, I've sort of lost track of where things are, where to go.
I'm sure you'll find your way around.
Well, I was hoping you'd like to show me some of your favourite places. You know, nightclubs, discos.
I can't stand noisy places, Mr. Harrison. And I'd like to eat my lunch in peace, if you don't mind. Staff room, Miss Bennett. Yes, straight away. This mightn't be the excitement you're looking for, Mr. Harrison, but come with me and I'll introduce you to the infamous B. Smith.
Hello, Miss Bennett.
We could have you dragged out, Smith. Now move.
Bea.
I hope you enjoyed your little jaunt, Smith. It'll be the last for quite some time.
Leave me alone. Please, Miss Bennett. Come on, Bea. You'll be all right.
Remanded in our custody until the 12th, at which time you will be brought to trial.
And Janet Brooks.
No bail has been affixed due to the fact that you were on parole at the time of your arrest. Is that correct?
Right.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
Mrs. Davison will see you when you're through here. I'm Jim Fletcher, the Deputy Governor.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Miss Bennett. I know how much that position meant to you.
You're right, Miss Bennett.
Come with me, Smith. I'm sure you remember the procedure, Brooks. Come on. Now, strip off and get ready for the showers.
Well, you don't expect me to get changed with you standing there, do you?
You'll do as I say, or I'll have it done for you. Some of the wind's been knocked out of your sails. Not that I'm surprised. You'll have at least 5 years added to the 10 you've still got to serve.
What is it that everyone thinks I've done? If someone would just tell me.
These will be kept in the dispensary.
But I need to take them every 6 hours.
Well, they can be issued just as easily from there.
Then, will it be all right if I keep my watch? I don't want to have to rely on the officers telling me when to take my tablets.
No! No! I haven't killed anyone, I haven't! But I swear, I don't know what she's talking about. Please, please, believe me!
You murdered your husband, Smith, 24 hours after being released for murdering your husband's lover.
Are you listening to me, Smith?
I wouldn't do anything to hurt my family. I couldn't!
Oh, that's very good, Smith. You must have been very busy at Barnhurst practicing this little routine.
Please, will you tell this woman to lay off me?
That's enough, Smith.
I think solitary will refresh her memory.
Thank you, Miss Bennet.
Come on.
Please stop grinning at me!
Get another officer to give you a hand.
Well, what do you think?
Well, it could be a ploy to get out of serving more time for escaping, you know, pleading loss of memory, not responsible for her actions, that sort of thing.
Well, we'd better get the sister to take a look at her. I'd like another opinion.
All right.
Well, now I'd better see Mum.
Okay. Brooks.
Doesn't seem 2 years ago, does it?
How could you do anything so stupid, especially for someone like Smith?
Is she going to get medical help?
If the need arises.
But you saw her. She's suffering from amnesia.
Possibly. Or perhaps she's just being extremely clever.
You can't mean that.
You are hardly in a position to say what I should or should not do.
Would it be all right if Bea moved in with me?
She will be under observation for 24 hours. After that, we shall see.
You used to rely on your instincts, Mrs. Davidson. I was hoping that hadn't changed.
My instincts told me that I would never see you back here again. So they are not very reliable, are they?
A bag, Lizzie?
Oh, fair, Margot.
That's me last package.
It's there for Cheddar. You're short, aren't you, Phil?
Yeah. Gee, thanks, Margot.
It's all right. Always look after your mates. Right?
I see. Things not quite the same without your friend Smith, is that it?
Both stupid.
There's no difference between Smith or Gaffney. They're both out for what they can get and they don't care who they use. Your friend Smith has just been responsible for having Mum arrested.
You mean Mum's back inside?
You'd never get Mum into strife. Never.
You can ask Smith yourself, once she's out of solitary.
Crikey, Jude. Bea's back.
Oh, beauty.
Sorry, Mum, I only got your message an hour ago.
I'll wait at the gate for you, Mrs. Morris.
Thank you.
Do you mind if I keep working? I don't want Miss Bennet finding fault with me on my first day.
I'll organise a barrister for you, but I'm sure you'll have to plead guilty. If you say you only helped Bea because you thought your life was in danger...
I can't say that.
But, Mum, you were caught handing her money. You have no other defence.
And what about Bea? If I admit that, it's as good as saying she was aware of what she was doing. She'll never get proper medical attention, and I'd be sentencing her to more time.
She'll be seeing a psychiatrist the next time he comes.
She'll be getting treatment now.
Do you want me to contact your family?
No. I'll write to them. Say I've gone away for a few days, at least until I know what happens at my trial. End of work. 15 minutes break before tea. You see, I haven't forgotten any of it.
But you still think Bea has?
I know she has, Mrs. Morris. The last 10 years are a blank. And once she does start remembering, it'll be like reliving every single dreadful moment.
Where's Mrs. Brooks? Why can't I be putting with her?
After what you did, she won't want anything more to do with you, Smith.
I didn't know she was on parole.
Of course not. You just went to her because she was the only one stupid enough to believe your performance.
Look, what have I ever done to you? Or are you like this with everyone?
Let's see if I can't jog your memory for you. Starting with your daughter.
What do you know about Debbie?
I was here when they told you that she died from an overdose. Remember?
She couldn't possibly be on drugs. I'd know. You're a liar.
Come on, Vera, that's enough. Just stay out of this. I want to see how long she can keep up this charade.
Well, count me out.
Please, please, just leave me alone.
But I want you to remember, Smith, how you felt when you heard she was dead. You wanted to go to her funeral, but I wouldn't let you because you couldn't be trusted even then.
But Jack would know. He would have stopped it. He loves her.
You were such a close family, weren't you?
Well, of course we were. All right, we had a fight a few days ago, but he's been flirting with one of the girls from work. I'm only human.
You blamed your husband for letting Debbie die, alone like that, of an overdose. Or at least that's why you said you murdered him. There again, he was always having sordid affairs. But of course you know that. That's why you murdered his mistress.